Okay, students, in previous class I explained about the climate of India under that two seasons, that is number one, that is winter season, number two, that is summer season. So next one, that is rainy season. If rainy season is completed, then seasons are completed. But here, in case, in the place of rainy season, I explained about the monsoons. What is that? Monsoons. So that's why we are going to discuss today monsoons. What type of monsoons are there in India? There are two monsoons are there in India. In India, is Indian agriculture is a magic in the hands of monsoons. Indian agriculture is a magic in the hands of monsoon. So monsoon magic lo Bharat Desh vyavasayam anedi aadharapadi undi. So rutupavanalu ane untayi ante monsoons rutupavanala meeda aadharapadi unna vyavasayam ante. So vaati gurinchi manam ee roju cheppukobothunnam. Veti gurinchi rutupavanalu, right? Ikkada meeru advancing monsoons gurinchi cheppukuntunnam manam. Advancing monsoons గురించి చెప్పుకునేటప్పుడు మొదట మనం ఇక్కడ ఇండియా మ్యాప్ వేసాను చూడండి ఒకసారి ఇండియా మ్యాప్ లో ఈ ఇండియా మ్యాప్ లో మనం మొదటిసారి అడ్వాన్సింగ్ మాన్సూన్ గురించి చెప్పుకుంటాం మాన్సూన్స్ ముందుగా వస్తే దాన్ని ఏమంటాం మాన్సూన్స్ లేట్ గా వస్తే దాన్ని ఏమంటాం లేట్ గా వస్తే లేట్ మాన్సూన్స్ ముందుగా వస్తే అడ్వాన్సింగ్ మాన్సూన్స్ ముందుగా వస్తే ప్రీ మాన్సూన్స్ లేటుగా వచ్చినాయి అనుకోండి పోస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ అంటే కరెక్ట్ పీరియడ్కి వచ్చినాయి అనుకోండి వాటిని ఆన్సెట్ మాన్సూన్స్ అంటాం మొత్తం మీకు మూడు పదాలు చెప్పాను నేను ఇక్కడ మాన్సూన్స్ ముందుగా వస్తే వాటిని ప్రీ మాన్సూన్స్ అంటాం మాన్సూన్స్ లేటుగా వస్తే వాటిని పోస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ అంటాం అలానే మాన్సూన్ కరెక్ట్ టైంకి వస్తే దాన్ని ఆన్సెట్ మాన్సూన్స్ అని అంటాం సరే మాన్సూన్స్ అనేవి మొదటిసారిగా మనం దేని గురించి చెప్పుకుంటామంటే సౌత్ వెస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ సౌత్ వెస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ సౌత్ వెస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ సౌత్ వెస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ సౌత్ వెస్ట్ మాన్సూన్ పీరియడ్ విల్ స్టార్ట్ జూన్ మంత్ జనరలీ ఇన్ జూన్ మంత్ సౌత్ వెస్ట్ మాన్సూన్స్ విల్ స్టార్ట్స్ June 1st, generally the monsoon will start June 1st. Suppose June 1st, it not comes, ultimately it comes, I mean May 15 or May 20. Suppose monsoon will enter into the June and May 20. So this is called pre-monsoon. Pre-monsoon. So monsoon is coming in advance monsoons are coming now, that's why it is called advanced monsoons. Which monsoons are advanced monsoons? I kept here title also. Southwest monsoons are called advanced monsoons. See here, this is the south part. Here, Bay of Bengal is there. Bay of Bengal. This side, Arabian Sea. This side Arabian Sea is there. This side Indian Ocean is there. Indian Ocean is there. So the monsoons are coming from southwest side. What is this? Is the south and this is called west side. The west side and the south side. The monsoons are coming. So these monsoons are called advanced monsoon. So first of all, we talk about and we discuss about the advanced monsoons. How the monsoons are coming? The monsoons are coming from Indian Ocean side. Towards one branch is going towards Bay of Bengal branch and one branch is going towards Arabian branch. But it moves towards North India. Here in North India, while these monsoons are coming at the time North India, in Tibet area, in Ganga plain area, low pressure will occupy. That's why the winds are blowing this side. That's why these winds, which is carries somewhat water vapor. These water vapor, when the blowing the winds very cool, then it gives somewhat rain. So due to this southwest monsoons, overall in India, we are getting high rainfall. It means a bulk of rainfall we are getting through southwest monsoon. This is the most important thing. So monsoons are coming from June 1st. Suppose monsoons are coming before the June, those are called pre-monsoon, or it is also known as monsoon burst. So monsoon burst, why it's happening, I will say. Monsoon burst and what is the relation between mango showers. So before June 1st, the monsoons are enter in India in Tamil Nadu, and it comes to towards Kerala. Generally monsoons are enter in South India, especially in Kerala only. The monsoons first enter, southwest monsoons first enter in which state? The state name is called Kerala. The southwest monsoons first enter in which state? Kerala. Later Tamil Nadu. And later Andhra Pradesh. And Karnataka. So, the first monsoons are, southwest monsoons are entering Kerala state. So, free monsoons are coming towards Kerala to Andhra Pradesh. At that time, mangoes are ready for ripe. So due to these little bit showers, the mangoes are ready for ripe, and it is useful for the mango crop in Andhra Pradesh. So such showers are called mango showers, caused by southwest monsoons. So what is called mango showers? What is called monsoon burst? They will ask you the question, these questions in examination point of view. So generally, southwest monsoons are start in June month. Before the monsoons are enter, it means monsoon burst or pre-monsoons. Those monsoons are useful for to wipe or to wipe the mangoes. So that's why those mangoes are ready to change into the green color to yellow color. So that's why these showers are called mango showers. Chinna chinna jallulu padtayi, chiru jallulu padtayi. Eppudaithe chiru jallulu padtoo untayo, ee chiru jallulu valla mangoes anevi ripe avadaniki siddhanga untayi, ante pandadaniki siddhanga untayi. So ee jallulu valla mangoes anevi pandutoo untayi kabatti veetini maamidi jallulu ledha mango showers ani antam jarugutoo undi. So later ikkada southwest monsoons, which is coming with two branches from Indian Ocean side. Two branches. Southwest monsoons are two branches. One is Bay of Bengal branch, one is Arabian Sea branch. Two branches. Ivanni 4-5 varallo, within 4 or 5 weeks, it expands throughout India. It reaches up to Meghalaya, Shillong. And here, Tibetan Plateau. Tibet area. Tibet Plateau. After it reaches. There, low pressure is happened. So that's why these high pressure winds are blowing towards the low pressure area. So Ganga plains also low pressure composed. And after it reaches up to eastern part, Shillong part, Meghalaya, Shillong part, and it reaches northern part, that is a Tibet plateau area. And at that time, within, you suppose, onset monsoons means the monsoons are coming exactly in time, in June month. So that is known as onset monsoon. Suppose the monsoons are coming after the period means post monsoons. Monsoons coming before June month, it is known as pre-monsoons or monsoon burst. I said three important words. So when monsoons are starting June 1st, it occupies or it moves throughout India within 4 or 5 weeks. Monsoons expands or monsoon moves and occupies within 4 or 5 weeks. Within 4 or 5 weeks it occupies throughout India. And bulk of plenty of rains and bulk of rain getting by India through southwest monsoon or advanced monsoons. So this is the most important part. And later, next part, what that is now? Retreating monsoons. What is that? Retreating monsoons. Under retreating monsoons, very important one, I will say that is October heat. After advancing monsoons is over now. Now I am going to discuss about what that is retreating monsoons. Retreating monsoons. So retreating monsoon, what is meant by retreating monsoon? Or it is also known as northeast monsoon. Northeast monsoon. I said advanced monsoon are called are also known as southwest monsoon. Now retreating monsoon or northeast monsoon. Now say in the same way, after completion of this one, northeast monsoon, what is called northeast monsoon? The monsoons which is started in October month, October, November, December, and December month, it carry on. Generally June month to June, July, August, September month, the monsoons are going on. That is a southwest monsoons. After September middle or October, the monsoons will be started. The monsoons are called retreating monsoons or northeast monsoons. So why these monsoons are called northeast monsoons? Because the monsoons are coming from this direction, and eastern direction and northern direction. In what is the rainfall in southern India at the time of south west monsoons? That is the most important question and coming in the examination. So what is the rainfall condition in southern India, especially Coromandel coast or Tamil Nadu or Chennai area? What is the rainfall in southwest monsoon season? There is a low rainfall which is recorded in southwest monsoon period in Tamil Nadu area or Coromandel coast area or southern India area. But plenty of rain, bulk of rain which is coming throughout India due to southern southwest monsoon. So that is a very important point I stressing for you. And one more important thing here is retreating monsoons are also called northeast monsoons. Northeast monsoons, which is a starting period, that is called September middle or October month. Generally October 1st the monsoons will be start, or September 15th the monsoons will be start. So when the monsoons will be start, these monsoons will give showers in North India, and plenty of rains which is occurred in Southern India. So due to North and Southern, Northern India and Southern India, what is that I am saying about these two monsoons? From Northeast monsoons, Southern India getting highest rainfall, and overall India getting highest rainfall due to Southwest monsoons. So this is the most important thing. So when the monsoons will be start in Southern India, what is the position of the Southern India? When the monsoons will start and it gives rain in North India, especially Northeast monsoons, at the time what the thing was happen in Southern India? So in Southern India, high humidity and there is no wind blowing, so that's why temperature is also increasing very high. Due to that, this low pressure, due to low pressure, the wind is blowing towards the Indian Ocean side. Then the Indian Ocean side, after this is the thing was happened in October month. In October month in Tamil Nadu area, especially Chennai and coastal area, high temperatures are recorded. That is nearly more than 37 degrees, and the lot of humidity and pressure which is happen in the environment. Due to that, manam sadharanam cheppukunta okka posta undi okka posta undi gaali led antunna. ఇటువంటి సందర్భం ఎప్పుడు జరుగుతుంది అంటే ఎక్కడ జరుగుతుంది ఎప్పుడు జరుగుతుంది అంటే తమిళనాడు కోస్టల్ ఏరియాలో, ఆంధ్రాలో కొద్ది శాతం, తమిళనాడు కోస్టల్ ఏరియాలో ఎక్కువగా జరుగుతుంది. ఈ సందర్భంలో ఇక్కడ ఉన్న లో ప్రెజర్, బాగా వేడి వాతావరణం ఏదైతే ఉంటుందో, ఈ వేడి వాతావరణం హిందూ మహాసముద్రం వైపు వెళ్తుంది. హిందూ మహాసముద్రం వైపు వెళ్ళి హిందూ మహాసముద్రం వైపు నుంచి కొన్ని పవనాలని, కొన్ని గాలుల్ని మన ఇటువైపు తీసుకొని వస్తుంది. హిందూ మహాసముద్రంలో అప్పుడేమవుతుంది, లో ప్రెజర్ కంపోజ్ అవుతుంది. ఏమవుతుంది, లో ప్రెజర్ అనేది కంపోజ్ అవుతుంది హిందూ మహాసముద్రంలో. దీని వలన సైక్లోన్స్ అనేవి ఏర్పడతాయి. అందుకని నవంబర్ మంత్ ని సైక్లోన్స్ మంత్ అని అంటున్నాము. సో దిస్ ద థింగ్ వాజ్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇన్ నార్త్ ఈస్ట్ ఈస్టర్న్ మాన్సూన్స్ ఓన్లీ. సో ఐ సెడ్ అబౌట్ వాట్ అబౌట్ ద సదరన్ ఇండియా అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ అక్టోబర్ హీట్. వాట్ ఈస్ మెంట్ బై అక్టోబర్ హీట్? October heat means at the time of retreating monsoon period in October month in coastal area, especially Tamil Nadu area, in Chennai area, high temperatures are recorded and humidity and moisture is more in the environment. So that's why low pressure which is happen, and total the hot wind is blowing towards Indian Ocean side, then Indian Ocean side, then what happens? Indian Ocean side later low pressure, there somewhat pressure which is happen in the Indian Ocean, that pressure creates somewhat cyclones. What that is? Cyclones. So cyclones which is happen October month, high temperature and humidity which is recorded, and low pressure is happen, the hot wind is blowing towards Indian Ocean side. But In November month, cyclones, depressions which is happen in Indian Ocean side, and cyclones are occurred in coastal belt from Coromandel coast and Sarkar coast and Utkal coast up to that Sundarbans area in West Bengal. So it is targeted to coastal areas and delta areas also. So the coastal, total coastal area and deltas areas getting a high rainfall due to this cyclones. This is about North East monsoon period. So students, I explained about two monsoons with a detailed manner. You go through the monsoons pictures, and afterwards VZV SH. VZV SHS process I explained in 8th class for all the students. That is Telugu seasons. In coming class I will explain.